You know, magnesium is needed in a lot of different functions in the body. It's a cofactor in many different biochemical pathways, but its primary purpose is to act as a calcium antagonist. Now, calcium is very toxic in the body unless it's in normal amounts. And if you are over 50 in female and are told that you need to take calcium as in some supplement, this video is for you. But if you're taking 500 milligrams or more of calcium every day, that has a potential to increase your risk of heart attacks as well as your risk for a stroke. Why? Because calcium is very toxic in the body unless it's in normal amounts. In fact, calcium is essential. We need it desperately, but we need it in smaller amounts. Calcium does not exit the body very easily. We tend to hold on it. And there's many different disease processes out there involving the accumulation of calcium, especially building up calcium in your arteries. This is why one of the best tests that you can do for that would be a CAC test, a coronary artery calcification test or scan. And I personally had that scan. I'll put a link down below so you can watch the video on that. But the test is very quick, it's relatively inexpensive, but it'll give you some really good data on predicting mortality from heart attacks. But it's going to measure the calcium in the coronary artery. And so magnesium is the key mineral to help prevent that. Now, there's also vitamin K2 that is also involved right there. I'm just bringing this up because there are some people that are taking supplements and they're taking calcium every single day, and they don't realize that it's actually quite harmful. I don't ever recommend taking a lot of calcium. The way I know that a lot of people are taking calcium is all you have to do is look at the top selling multivitamin minerals in the world and just pick up the bottle. It's going to be really heavy, like it's almost like a paperweight. That's because the first ingredient is calcium carbonate. Not a good thing to take because of this right here. If you're taking a multivitamin mineral, read the ingredients and make sure it doesn't have the calcium carbonate. And it's really kind of bizarre to me that you would put that as the first ingredient in a multivitamin mineral. And that's because anytime you have the first ingredient, that makes up the bulk of that product. And calcium carbonate, which is limestone, is extremely cheap. It's like basically eating rocks. And they're selling these rocks with some synthetic vitamins, and you think you're getting something that's quality when you're not. And these products are very, very cheap. Okay, so then we have a condition called hypercalcemia, too much calcium in the blood. Sometimes people ask me, what about vitamin D? Is that going to cause hypercalcemia? First of all, you would have to take extreme amounts, extremely large amounts of vitamin D, like over 100,000 IUs, maybe over 200,000 IUs, and take it for months before you would develop that. Okay, so when we're talking about much smaller levels, like 10,000 or 20,000 or even 30,000 IUs of vitamin D3, that's not what I'm talking about when I'm saying extreme large amounts. But if you have hypercalcemia, here are the symptoms: arrhythmias, abdominal pain, paralytic ileus. That means your colon has shut down, it's obstructed, but there's nothing physical that it's blocking your colon. That's because the calcium is interfering with the other electrolytes that help you in the contraction of the smooth muscle in your colon. Okay, vomiting is a symptom. Excessive urination or reduced urination. Interesting. Psychosis, strong desire for sleep, and constipation. Now, you can get magnesium from consuming a lot of salads like leafy greens. Pumpkin seeds have a good amount of magnesium. Avocado is a good source, and nuts are a good source as well. If you want more information about that CAC test, I put a link down. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.